I recently read this quote that said, either you give up or you keep going, and they both hurt. And man, that quote really hit hard. Because either way, it's gonna hurt, but what's gonna hurt more? What's up, all my beautiful divine souls? Welcome back to Vibe Divine. If you are new here, my name is Amira, and if you are returning, welcome back. Man, let me tell you, the last 2 weeks, let's just say this entire month, period, has been a test of whether or not I'm going to keep going, keep forging, pushing past the barriers, or whether I am going to let up off the gas and say, forget it. I had so many issues with recording last week and trying to get content out there. I was having sound issues, technical difficulties, and usually being able to follow my normal schedule just wasn't happening. And to be honest with you, you know, I was feeling a little discouraged and just really being hard on myself. Like, I noticed sometimes, you know, when it comes to wanting to get things right and having this like kind of like perfectionism in a way, it really just kind of puts you on a halt and stops you from moving forward. So the challenge to myself is do the best that I can, you know, put out good quality content and, you know, just don't overthink it so much. So, you know, I put out a video called The Spiritual Flu. And that video had all kinds of sound issues. So if you did see it, all the 30 people who did see it, firstly, thank you for watching. And secondly, I really apologize for the poor sound quality. I tried everything in my power to make the situation better. But at the end of the day, you have to know when to just fold it and start over. So this is me starting over, because will I give up? No. So here I am again to talk about the spiritual flu. Now, you know, if you are going through what I call the spiritual flu, you may be wondering, what in the world is that? You know, I've heard of the physical flu that you get and it makes you feel really crappy. But what is the spiritual flu? And this, of course, is something that you'll have to use your own discernment with, because if you did end up going to the doctor, most likely they would probably end up telling you that there's nothing actually physically wrong with you. So if there's nothing actually physically wrong with you, then what's going on and why are you experiencing such heavy, intense physical symptoms that literally feel like you're sick and that you actually do have the flu? So this is a process that is very metaphysical in nature. And as ascension accelerates, you are literally bringing in and holding more light. So this may take the body some time to adjust to these higher vibrational frequencies that are coming in as you continue to grow and expand in consciousness. We just had 2 full moons in the month of August. And, you know, full moons by themselves can be very intense, bringing up a lot of unresolved emotions. But the second full moon was a very rare super blue moon, as it only happens every 9 years. And it was the closest moon to the Earth in 2023. So as you can imagine, this is very potent energy that's going to affect your physical, mental, and emotional bodies. And when we think about full moons, what do they represent? A time of cleansing, purging, releasing, just, you know, letting go of what no longer serves us. So, you know, these energies, along with other energies, are coming in at an accelerated rate to help us to really let go of any old thoughts, patterns, and beliefs, and any heavy, dense energy as we begin to move into a more lighter, authentic version of ourselves. And you know, this is all for the betterment of your life, but this doesn't come without those, you know, icky, not so fun, intense symptoms of ascension. You know, you might have repressed memories that will come up, you know, seemingly out of nowhere, or traumas that come up that are being triggered. And this is all for you to go within, look at, you know, heal and, you know, process and finally let it go. You may experience people that were in your life potentially holding back. You'll notice that either the dynamic completely shifts or these people just will completely disappear out of your life. Maybe the things that you used to do are no longer resonating with you, and now you want to choose to do something else. Or maybe you used to really love doing something, or you just now have a new passion for doing something and you want to pursue it now. So it really depends. Maybe your hobbies will change. Maybe you move locations. Maybe your job changes as the old job no longer resonates with you. And again, this is all just pushing you in the right direction towards your full authenticity. Now, when we talk about some of these, you know, intense symptoms, what symptoms am I talking about as you begin to balance these new energies? So this can include maybe you're feeling feverish, or you're experiencing headaches, or extreme fatigue, like you're just so tired you don't feel like doing anything. Even if you've had 8 hours of sleep and you wake up feeling like you were fighting all night, completely exhausted. Maybe you're having muscle aches or back pains or anxiety, hot flashes, heart palpitations, dizziness, nausea. You can experience, you know, irritability and mood swings. Like, the list goes on with some of these symptoms that you could be experiencing. Possibly your desire for food could change. Maybe you become more hungry or less hungry. It depends on the person, but I think that you just become more sensitive energetically overall, and the things that used to resonate with you just no longer resonate with you. So, you know, all of this is happening for a reason, for a purpose, and it's happening for you and not to you. But if we're not aware of what's going on, then it can be really kind of scary and overwhelming. But I think that if we are aware, it can confirm to us that, hey, one, I'm not crazy, you know, and this is happening for a reason. And if I know what's going on, then I can access the tools to, you know, help me get through to the other side. So, you know, with that being said, I wrote down a list of things that you could do. What can you do to help you through this process and get to the other side, you know, a little bit quicker than, let's say, if you didn't know what was going on? So the first thing I would say is presence. Have full presence and awareness of what's going on without trying to distract yourself or repress those emotions that are wanting to come up. Be there, be present, give them awareness, and allow them to express themselves. Listen to what the pain is trying to teach you, what clarity is coming up for you, and what is it that you need to do moving forward. So I think when we can have presence without abandoning ourselves, we allow. It comes up, we're present with it, we allow, and that is when we create the space to release, which then is the healing that we're looking for. Well, the next thing I would say is rest. Now, in a culture where it's all about do, sometimes we may, you know, feel guilty about resting. And I'm not saying that you let up off of your goals or the things that you're trying to achieve in this world. But what I am saying is that your body is doing a lot, and that is amazing. So, you know, give your body the time to adjust to these new energies that are coming in, and rest if you need to, even if it's just for a day. Don't feel guilty about it. Rest. And everything that you were doing is, trust me, it's going to be there when you're done. The next thing I would say is to hydrate. I know that we can forget to hydrate in our busy schedules, but hydrate. Drink a lot of water. Hydration can come from other things like coconut water or organic fruit juice without any added sugars. I like to take a whole watermelon and put it in the juicer and just drink that baby. And trust me, you get so much hydration from a watermelon. I don't know, some people who don't even drink water, they just get their hydration from, drinking fruit juice from a juicer. So it really depends on what your preference is, but hydrate, because our bodies are made up of mostly water, and this is going to help with the process of integrating and releasing and letting these things go. So hydrate. Next thing I would say is give your body the foods that it needs to, maintain optimal health. And these are going to be foods that are alive, foods that are alive have light codes that are connected to the earth, as we are also connected to the earth. So, getting these foods that are going to be better for our system will help with this integration process. Also, I would say, and this goes hand in hand, is ground. Go out in nature. Sit on the ground. I'm inside today, and I tried to record this video outside last time, but because I had so many issues with sound, I just decided to come inside and do this video. But go outside, walk in the grass, do yoga outside, meditate outside, sit in the sun. The sun is our friend, and it too has energetic light codes that are assisting us through this ascension process. It, it is healing us and really helping to assist us. So get all the sun that you can. The next thing I would say is listen to frequency music or light language. And if you're unsure what light language is, it's an angelic language, an original language of the stars, sort of say, that bypasses straight through your conscious mind to your subconscious mind, getting you the healing that you really, really need. This along with frequency music, as it helps to raise your vibration. And this is something that really, really helped me, because I had so much pressure in my crown chakra in my head. Like, just listening to frequency music and light language just helped me to release so much energy. Like, I just begin to cry and cry and cry and let go. And that's another thing, allow yourself to cry, because as you know, crying is like cleansing. It's also very releasing in nature. So crying is a good thing. This one is very important, I would say, is deep, deep breathing. Bring in that primordial life force itself to help you cleanse these energies, in with the new, out with the old. And this will help to ground you and, make you alive during the process. So don't forget to breathe. And it's going to help speed it up too with deep, deep breathing. This next one is also really important, which, may not seem like something physical in nature that we can do, but it really helps. And that is set healthy boundaries. As we move into the space of more authenticity, no longer will we be able to ignore ourselves. So if that's hanging out with people that we don't want to hang out with, being in places that we don't want to be, doing things that we don't want to do, the body is going to send you an alarm in the form of anxiety telling you, hey, 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 something is off and I don't like this. So it's better to be in balance with yourself, in your full authenticity, and listening to your intuition, as it will not lead you astray. Giving yourself self-love and honor, setting those boundaries. Last thing I would say is really just be kind to yourself. I know this can be a very intense process of moving through all these energies and releasing everything that no longer serves us, especially if we've been doing it in little chunks and now it's coming in at such a faster accelerated rate. It can be very overwhelming. Trust me, I know this is something that has happened to me on my journey multiple times and has recently happened to me in my personal life. And I was literally like sick for like 2 whole days, you know what I mean? But applying some of these tools and really just being present with it helped me along the way. One more thing that I forgot to mention was do movement. Like, I know that can be hard if you're already exhausted and you don't feel like moving or exercising, but really exercise or do yoga,
Because this helps to, get the energy flowing, get the body flowing, and trust me, you'll feel a lot less fatigued and a lot less tired. Even if it's just for 15 minutes a day, even if you're just taking a walk or doing something light, but try to get your body moving. So this is me doing this video for the fourth time, and I hope that you were able to receive something beneficial from this video. I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below on your journey with ascension and intense symptoms that come along with it. So I love you. God loves you. Continue to live in love and light. Let this be a testament never to give up. And of course, as always, until next time, take care of you.